If you're a business owner, you know how important a Google Business Profile ranking in the Map Pack is. In this video, I want to share with you yet another tip that you can start deploying easily, cheaply, that will absolutely help optimize your Google Business Profile. Now, the actual element that I'm talking about within the listing is going to be the questions and answers. Now, let me go ahead and show you on my own business profile exactly what I'm talking about. So, if we look up Chris Palmer Marketing briefly, this is one of my listings. And when you take a look at the knowledge panel, this piece over here on the right-hand side of the screen, this is the knowledge panel. This is the Google Business Profile listing. When you scroll on down here, you can see that there is what there is called questions and answers. As you can see, I currently have loaded in 5 different questions with answers. Now, oftentimes when you're filling this out, you're wondering to yourself, well, what do I put in here? What should I talk about? Well, this is exactly what I want to go ahead and give you so you could be the most optimal when filling out your questions and answers. Now, I know you as a business owner, you probably already know some questions right off the bat, but when it comes to optimization, you want to use very specific keywords, and here is how you find those keywords, and then you'll know exactly what to put inside of your questions and answers in your Google Business Profile. Let me go ahead and share that with you now. So if you take a look here, let's say that you are a, what are you? Are you a lawyer? So let's say that you're a lawyer. All right. So lawyer, and we're going to look up lawyer in Los Angeles. All right. So you're a lawyer in Los Angeles. You want to optimize your Google Business Profile for questions and answers. You're not sure which questions and answers you should be filling in. Let me go ahead and show you this. So if you scroll down here just a little bit, you're going to see a section here called People Also Ask. People have questions, right? So these are the most common questions when talking about the specific keyword, lawyer Los Angeles, but it doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be lawyer Los Angeles. You could be a plumber in Minnesota. You could be a doctor. You could be a pet store owner. You could be any type of business owner under the sun, and you're going to be able to have this pop up. And if it doesn't pop up for you, then just do a slight variation of the primary keyword. Primary keyword meaning, instead of putting lawyer Los Angeles, if it didn't show up for that, I would put lawyer Los Angeles CA or California Los Angeles doctor or California, right? You get what I'm saying here? Make a variation in order to pop the question. So all you would simply do then is take a look at this. How much does a lawyer cost in Los Angeles? Probably a common question for yourself, right? So how much does it cost? How do I find a good lawyer in Los Angeles? How much does it cost to hire a lawyer in California, right? California is related to Los Angeles. So they're giving you the questions. If you want to get more, all you do is press this button. It will keep giving you more questions. These are the most relevant questions to your keyword. This is your keyword. These are the most relevant questions that you can add to your Google Business Profile. This way you're the most semantically correct. With that being said, I want to point out one more small little tweak. When you do a drop down here, you're going to notice that Google is going to bold out particular terms. When you're asking and answering your questions, right? Whether you have 2 profiles and you're doing this for your own business, if you take a look here, see how they're bolding these particular phrases up inside of the answer? This is to show how relevant the result is. All right, they found this inside of the answer. They're pointing out, hey, look how relevant our result is. They bolded this up to showcase how relevant it is. So what I'm leaning towards is here is how you go ahead and start filling out, curating your questions and answers based on people also asked after typing in a keyword. And I'll give you one more example. All right, let me give you one more example just to hammer this home. So you have a business. That means your business is also related to a specific keyword. Let's say that you are a chiropractor. You're a chiropractor in Texas. All right, so chiropractor Texas is your primary keyword. You put your keyword in, you scroll down to the bottom, people also ask, all right? We're looking to get 5 to 10 questions to add to our Google Business Profile that are semantically correct. We'll know that they're semantically correct based on Google has provided these for us. Now, when we're filling out our questions and then our answers, you want to go ahead and do a drop down. And when you're curating your answer, make sure that you're adding some of the bolded terms to make sure that you're listing your answer is just as relevant as the ones that they show in the search result. All right, so that is Google Business Profile Optimization. That's another tip just for you. My name is Chris Palmer. If there's anything at all that I could help you with related to Google Maps, Google My Business, really anything, local SEO, affiliate SEO, national SEO, anything, never hesitate. Always go ahead and ask in the section below. If you need services, go to services.chrispalmermarketing.com. If there's anything I can do for you, let me know. And I look forward to seeing you in the next Google My Business, Google Business Profile Optimization video. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.